Okay, so in this lesson, we're going to create some service control policies and apply them. Now, the infrastructure we have is slightly different to this. We have the root, and then we have a master account in root. And then under organizational units, I have an organizational unit, and I'm gonna create a second organizational unit, and that's where we're gonna put our DCT SysOps account, so the account we're trying to control. And then I'm actually gonna apply the service control policy to this one here. So let's head over to the console and build this out. So I'm in AWS Organizations. You can see on the left here, we've got root and then OU1. And I've got my root account and then I've got my DCT SysOps account. And there's another account already in OU1. So what I'm gonna do is let's go into OU1 and I'm gonna create a new organizational unit called OU2. So now we've got a hierarchy. I'm gonna come back up, take this account and move it into OU2. So now if we go into OU2, we've got our account. Now on OU2, if we go to service control policies, what you'll see is we've got the full AWS access. So that's the one that applies to all accounts by default. And that gives us all the permissions. But what we're gonna do now is we're gonna create a policy. So let's go to service control policies, create policy, and we're gonna head over to our code and we've got some code for this one. So this is the code we need. It's in your AWS organizations directory in your course download. And this is the T2 micro file. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna copy this code exactly as it is, come back and paste this into the editor. And let's call this T2 micro only. And that's all we need to do, just create policy. Now you do have to have service control policies enabled for this. So once that's been created, what we can do now is go back to our organizational unit. Let's go to service control policies, and then we want to attach that service control policy. And now we'll go over to the account, so to this DCT SysOps account, and we're gonna try and launch an instance that isn't a T2 micro. So I'm back on the other account. So I'm on the account now that's being controlled, that has the SCP applied to it. So let's go to running instances. Let's launch an instance. And I'm gonna select, and I'm gonna change to T2 small. And then let's just go straight to try and launch this instance. And there you go, we get a fail that says you're not authorized to perform this operation. So that's failing because of the policy that's applied. If I now go straight back, and this time I'm just gonna accept the defaults and use a T2 micro, and let's launch that one. This time it launches just fine. So that shows that we're restricting the ability to launch anything but a T2 micro instance. There's another policy that I'm gonna apply. This is to show you how you can stop people from deleting buckets. Now in this particular example, I've got SCP test bucket here. So that's the bucket I'm gonna create in my account. So just create yourself a bucket and then put the ARN in here. I'm gonna copy this code and let's go back to policies, service control policies, and we'll create another policy. Again, just paste all that code in. So make sure that you do update your bucket name. I'm gonna go over and make sure I can create that bucket now. So let's go to S3, create bucket, and it's gonna be called SCP-test-bucket. Great, so I've got that bucket. I've pasted the code in and my bucket name is correct. So let's call this prevent bucket deletion and let's create that policy. And now we'll go back to our OU again. Click on service control policies and we can attach prevent bucket deletion. So let's give this one a go. So back in Amazon S3, I'm gonna try and delete this bucket. And I've gotta put in the bucket name. Let's click on delete, and I get an error. So it's saying delete bucket failed. Access is denied. So now if we just head back, I'm gonna detach that policy, and this should have an effect pretty much immediately. So let's try and delete that bucket again, and this time we get a success. So that's how to use service control policies. And you'll find that those particular examples can come up in the exam and other ones as well. But the key thing to remember is whatever comes up in your exam questions, remember that SCP is all about controlling the API actions that you're able to perform, but you still need the permissions to be able to actually perform those actions as well. So it's a combination of service control policies and IAM permissions, which you can use to control who is able to do what in the linked accounts. Thank you.